In this video, Simon's going to be comparing the Nike Invincible 3 against his new shoes, the ASICS Superblast, people. Yeah, he's bought the Superblast. What is up, guys, and welcome to the channel. Now, hopefully, you've seen one or two of the videos we did on the Nike Invincible 3. Now, I didn't buy them. Simon bought them, and I would say he was less than complimentary about them. Okay, right, so I'll put up some stats and features on the screen, but basically, Invincible 3 has got just under 40 mil of stack, all Zoom X, really good outsole, terrible upper, weighs about as much as that riverboat, and it's 170 quid. That's about it, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then we've got the ASICS Superblast, two phones, Flight Phone Blast Plus, I think we've got Turbo in there, or I can't remember exactly what it's in, it would have been on the screen. We've got over 40 mil of stack, no carbon plane either, jackhard mesh upper, both fit true to size. But here's the kicker with the ASICS, 225 quid. It might have been actually less than 225, might be 209, anyway, don't matter. So that's where we're at. I absolutely love the shoe. But to be fair, they are a comparable shoe, I would say. They are an easy shoe to run in. You can do marathon training in them. You know, they're not an overall speed shoe, but they're comfortable for some to wear at those sort of goal paces and stuff like that, right? That's probably a fair way of putting it. Yep, time's off. Speed goes in his Max Road 5s, by the way, in this review. Natch. Right, so let's go over to the main man and find out, firstly, why he bought them, how much he paid for them, and what he thinks of them. Right, so Si, you obviously did, well, documented, didn't get on with the Invincible 3. So what's happened to them?
Well, basically, they've now become a trainer for the jeans.
Okay, so going to Lakeside,
yeah,
wearing the Max, wearing the...
never to be running again.
No, yeah, 170 quid mistake, that's life. But what I would say is, he didn't say they're a terrible shoe, it's just it didn't work for him, right?
I'm just not going to run in them.
So you were looking, and we said this in the video, for a shoe that you could do these sort of runs on, right?
Yeah.
We're doing 18 miles today, pretty easy, but we will drop the goal. It's multi-terrain, and you need something that's comfortable and easy going, right?
Yeah.
So, he then went on, was it eBay?
So basically, I have been looking for a pair of Superblast for a long time.
Yeah, which is why I ended up with the Invincible 3s, because he couldn't get them, right?
But I just sort of, I didn't want to pay the £209.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was just too much to justify. So anyway, looking around, nothing. See a pair on eBay. Geezer had them up for 165 quid, but make an offer.
Yeah.
Hello, balled him, 100 quid. He refused. I think 105 he refused, went 110 he refused. Then he came back to me 2 days later and said, will you pay 130? I said, yes. All day long. Bought them for 130, brand new in the box. They got sent to eBay.
Authenticated.
Then sent to me, got them 2 days later. Best 130 quid I spent.
Bosh. Right, so Si, what do you like about the shoe, firstly, and then we'll compare it against the Nova Blast, the Invincible 3.
I would say the comfort.
Yeah.
The ride.
Yeah. What do you like about the ride? Quantify it.
Even when you're even at a slow pace like this.
Yeah.
You do feel there is a response.
Yeah, okay.
And also, but then, as soon as you pick the pace up as well, you can get right on your toes. It does sort of propel you forward even.
Even though it's got no plate?
Yeah.
How do you find the extra stack? Obviously it's a high stack. Notice it?
I don't notice anything or that feels weird.
Yeah.
It just feels just right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's a nice blend,
the foam, in terms of this. It's soft, but it's not like dangerous soft like the fuel cell. It's just,
no,
they've really done it sweet, haven't they? The balance on the phone. I find it very stable.
Yeah.
And I think that's because it's quite a wide platform at the back.
Yeah.
You're spread. If you know what I mean, the back of your foot is spread, so you're not. Yeah.
It's quite a long shoe as well, which I think it also helps with the stability. It feels long, doesn't it?
Yeah, so I've got them out and I thought, God, they'd be big.
Yeah.
But they are an 8.5 true size, they fit fine.
Yeah, fit true size. Okay, right, let's compare them next to the Invincible 3. Right, so versus the Invincible, in terms of the ride, what would you say is the biggest noticeable difference?
the softness.
Right.
It's
in which one?
In the Super Blast.
Yeah.
It's a lot softer, a lot springier. Doesn't feel dead like the Invincible.
Okay, you feel like you've got some bounce and
yeah, you're like
okay.
You can spring about in it. It's a nice place to be.
Right. Okay. And then, I have to say,
and I'm not running the Invincible 3. But I would say the Invincible 3's outsole is about 150 times better than this.
It is. The outsole down here will get cut up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But a lot of shoes are like that, aren't they?
Yeah, but I've found with the Superlast, it's the only thing that lets it down is its outsole.
There's a good grip, but I wouldn't even say that, to be honest with you, bro.
I was running them the other day. You've been lucky since you got yours. It's been dry.
Yeah, true.
I was running the other week and it was a bit creasy when we went out. I was slip sliding about all over the place, thank you. It was a bit pony, to be honest. It's the only thing that sits down. That's the only, I would say, positive of the Invincible 3 is its outsole versus these. Okay, right, let's conclude it. So, let's give some metrics. Invincible 3, what would you rate it out of 10? Be fair though, don't be horrible.
No, I'll still give it the 5 I gave it. It ain't a bad shoe, it's just not for me. Like you say, the outsole's good, but.
That's about it.
Just how about when you're wearing your jeans? What would you give me when you're wearing your jeans?
About 100 out of 10.
Do look good, actually. Do look really good. I saw a geezer. Sorry about it before we did the video. I saw a geezer in London.
And that is the thing. Wearing a pair of jeans on or a pair of shorts.
And they're nice.
And you're walking around in London.
Every day.
And they are comfortable.
Yeah, and then you went down a treadmill run. Job done, isn't it?
Nothing wrong with them.
That's the thing with them, right? Mental free. That's a lifestyle shoe, right?
It's like, look, these are fluff. I wouldn't wear them with jeans.
No, that's what I'm saying to you. The Invincible 3 is a lifestyle shoe, and that's not a bad thing, where the Super Blast is a running shoe. And that, I think,
a proper running shoe.
Is the difference.
No.
Okay, right, so lastly, rating for the Super Blast?
I'd give it so far solid 9.
Yeah, honestly. It's such a good shoe.
And look,
but he's giving it a 9 based on what he paid.
Yeah.
I think if you pay 200 and whatever, you wouldn't be giving it.
Being funny, if it was 209, I still wouldn't have a pair.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the other thing.
And that's the annoying thing, right, with the Super Blast, is the price. I just wish.
If it was 179,
yeah,
I would have got them ages ago.
Yeah, because you get a Start Fitness with a 10% code, job done, right? You're in business, aren't you?
And then you will see your deal about.
Yeah. And they need some better colourways. That's the only thing. Colourway,
not great.
Bit pony. Considering how many nice colourways they're launching Nimbus in, you'd thought they'd done a better job. But anyway.
Doesn't seem like they're pushing this that much.
No, they're not, because people ain't buying them because they're so bleeding expensive.
But the price ain't coming down.
I know. Anyway, right, so look. Bottom line, we both recommend the Super Blast. He recommends the Super Blast over the Invincible 3. Tobe recommends the what, Tobe?
Max Row 5.
68 quid. And I think we'll leave the video there. Right, say bye, boys.
Bye, boys.
Bye. Catch you later.